Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the previous class we completed the chapter subtraction, right? We completed the chapter subtraction. So in today's class we'll be starting with the next chapter, that is called multiplication. All right, so what is multiplication? You all have learned multiplication as repeated addition, correct? So multiplication is nothing but it is defined as to calculate the result of repeated additions of two numbers, right? So this is how you have learnt multiplication. It is a repeated addition. So we'll see a first, what we'll do is we'll see a few problems on how you'll have learnt multiplication in second standard, okay? And then what we'll do is we'll see multiplication of number tables. We'll see what are tables from 1 to 10, and we'll also see what are properties of multiplication. So here first, now they have told look at the pictures and fill in the facts. Okay, look at the pictures and fill in the facts. Now first here we have a bunch of bananas. So how many bunches are there? First of all, we have four bunches, correct? 1, 2, 3, 4. And in each bunch, how many bananas are there? There are 3. 1, 2, 3. So now to calculate the total number of bananas together, what you will do, you will add 3 4 times because there are 4 sets of bananas. So 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. Or what you can do, you can just do 3 into 4 because 3 bananas are there in and there are 4 sets. So 3 into 4, 12. Okay, so that is 3 into 4, 12. So this was one example. Now let's solve the other problems that they have given here. Now here we have a few watches and there are 3 sets. So this is one set of watches, 2 and 3. Now let's see how many watches are there in each set. So in first set we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 watches. Correct. And then in the second set how many we have? Again we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 watches. And in the last set also we have 5 watches. So 5 plus 5, 10. And 10 plus 5, 15. Correct? So we have 15 watches. Now here we have to write it as multiplication. How we'll write first? Number of watches in one set into the number of sets. So 5 into 3. So how much is it? It is 15. Okay, so 15. Now, next one. There are 2 sets of dice here. Okay, rolling dice. So, how many, first of all, in each set, how many dice are there? We have 1, 2, 3, 4. So, we'll do 4 here. So, 4 plus, then in the next set also, we have 4. So, 4 plus 4. Or, how many dice are there in one set? It is 4 and number of sets is 2. So, 4 into 2. That is 8. 4 2's is 8. Okay. Then we have a... we have sets of books here. How many sets we have? We have 1, 2 and 3 sets. First, let's see in each set how many books are there. So, in the first set, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 books. So, 6. Then in the second set, how many books we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, plus 6 again. And in the last set also, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6 plus 6 plus 6. Okay, so 3 sets. So in each set we have 6 books and there are 3 sets in total. So 6 into 3 is 18. Okay, 6 threes is 18. So this is how you do repeated addition. Let's see a few more questions on this. So here in the next page, fill in the blanks. So we have to fill in the blanks here. So let's see how to do this. So they have told 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 is equal to 4 into dash. So now you have to see how many times they have added 4, because 4 they have already given here. So we have to, in this blank, we have to write how many times they are adding 4. So how many times they are adding? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 times. So 4 into 5. So 4 into 5. How much is 4 5s are? 4 5s are is 20. Okay, so that is 20. Then next, we have 7 plus 7 plus 7. So, is equal to 7 into dash. Now, they are asking how many times you are adding 7. So, how many times we added 7 here? We added 7, 1, 2, 3 times. So 7 into 3. So how much is 7 into 3? 7 into 3 is 21. Okay, so 7 threes are 21. Then we have 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8. Correct? So how now what is the number that we are adding? We are adding 8. And how many times we added 8? We added it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. So 8 into 6. What is 8 into 6? 8 into 6 is 48. 8, 6 are 48. Now here they've told 9 into 3 and 9 plus. So you have to write it in addition form. So now they have told 9 into 3. So we are adding 9 3 times. So once is already given. So 9 plus 9 plus 9. So we added it 3 times. So that is how much is 9 into 3 or 9 plus 9 plus 9? It is 27. Okay, so then here they have told 10 into 4. So what we have to do now? You have to add 10 4 times. So 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. So that is you are adding 10 4 times. How much is that? That is 40. Okay. Now here next is skip count on the number strip. Okay, so you have done it. So let's see how to do it. So 6 into 2. So you are adding 6 2 times or you are multiplying 6 with 2. So what you will do? You will jump 6 steps 2 times. Okay, so this is once. So 0 to 6. And then you will count 6 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you will take a jump from 6 to 12. So you reached 12 now. Correct. So let's do the next one. So 6 to 12 is 12. Now we have 4 into 4. Now from first, from 0 to 4, we will do 1 jump. Then 4 to 8 because we have 1, 2, 3, 4. And again we'll count 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll jump from 8 to 12. Okay. And then from 12 to which number? When you count 4 forward, you'll jump to 16. Okay. You don't draw the curves like this. Draw it neatly. Okay. So how many times we jumped? 1. 2, 3, and this was 4. Correct. So how much is 4 fours are? 4 fours are is 16. Okay, 4 fours are is 16. So you all know how to do skip counting on number steps. So do the last two also in your books. Okay, so do it neatly. Right. So now let's see what are tables and what are the properties of multiplication. Okay, so these are first, you all have already learned tables in second standard, but these are just to recall your tables now. So what are the tables? Just say the tables once. So we have 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3, 1 4s are 4, 1 5s are 5, 1 6s are 6, 1 7s are 7, 1 8s are 8, 1 9s are 9, 1 10s are 10. So this was a 1 table. So whenever you multiply a number with 1, you always get that number itself. If you see here, 1 into 7 is 7, 1 into 8 is 8. Okay, so any number you multiply it with 1, that answer will be the number itself. Okay, then 2 table. 2 1s are 1, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 6s are 12, 2 7s are 14, 2 8s are 16, 2 9s are 18, and 2 10s are 20. So that is 2 table. Okay, this is 2 table. Then next we have 3 table. 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 18, 3 7s are 21. 3 8s are 24, 3 9s are 27, and 3 10s are 30. Correct. So that was the 3 table. Now after 3 we have 4 tables. So how will you do 4 tables? 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 24, 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16, 4 5s are 20, 4 6s are 24, 4 7s are 28, 4 9s are 32, and 4 10s are 40. Okay, so that is 4 tables. Then next 5 tables. So 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25, 5 6s are 30, 5 7s are 35, 5 8s are 40, 5 9s are 45, and 5 10s are 50. So these are tables from 1 to 5. Okay, these are tables from 1 to 5. So how do you get tables? It is nothing but when you keep adding the number with itself, you get. So 2 1s are 2, correct? 2 1s are 2. Then 2 2s are means when you add 2 plus 2, you get 4. So you're adding 2 times. Same way 2 3s are 6. So when you add 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 6. So you're adding 2 3 times, you get 6. So instead of you can just write 2 3s are 6. Okay, same way you get all the tables. Now next we have 6 tables. So 6 1s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 4s are 24, 6 5s are 30, 6 6s are 36, 6 7s are 42, 6 8s are 48, 6 9s are 54, 6 10s are 60. So that is 6 table. Then let's say 7 table now. So 7 1s are 7, 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21, 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35, 7 6s are 42, 7 7s are 49, 7 8s are 56, 7 9s are 63, and 7 10s are 70. Alright, so 7 table. Now 8 table. 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 8 3s are 24, 8 4s are 32, 8 5s are 40, 8 6s are 48, 8 7s are 56, 8 8s are 64, 8 9s are 72, 8 10s are 80. Then the next one, that is 9 tables. So 9 1s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 9 3s are 27, 9 4s are 36, 9 5s are 45, 9 6s are 54, 9 7s are 63, 9 8s are 72, 9 9s are 81, and 9 10s are 90. And then we have the last table, 10 table. So 10 1s are 10, 10 2s are 20, 10 3s are 30, 10 4s are 40, 10 5s are 50, 10 6s are 60, 10 7s are 70, 10 8s are 80, 10 9s are 90, and 10 10s are 100. So these are tables from 1 to 10. So you have to learn these tables properly and know the tables correctly. Okay, now we'll see what are properties of multiplication. So what are properties of multiplication? First one is the property of zero. So when any number is multiplied by zero, the result is always zero. Okay, so you multiply any number by zero, your result will be zero itself. So 7 into 0 is equal to 0. Then we have property of 1. What is property of 1? When you multiply any number with 1, the result is the number itself. I just showed you in the 1 table, correct? And whenever you multiply any number by 1, the result is the number itself. So 5 into 1 is 5. 10 into 1 is 10. Okay, 16 into 1 is 16. Like that, whenever you multiply any number by 1, the answer remains the number itself. So first property of 0, that is when you multiply a number with 0, the result is always 0. And property of 1, when you multiply a number with 1, the result is the number itself. Okay. Then we have order property. What is order property? The product of 2 or more numbers is the same, whatever be the order in which they are multiplied. So when you are multiplying 2 numbers, you can multiply them in any order. Okay, you can multiply them in any order, your result will remain the same. So here they have given example. 7 into 3 is 21, 3 into 7 is also 21. So you are changing the order of 7 into 3, but your answer is remaining 21 only. Then even when you multiply 3 numbers or more numbers. So see here, 2 into 6 into 5 is 60. Same with 2 into 5 into 6 is also 60. So 6 into 5 into 2 also will be 60. So you change the order anyhow of the three numbers, but the three numbers should remain the same. Okay, the final product remains the same. So this is order property of multiplication. Then multiplication with 10, 100 and 1000. When a number is multiplied with 10, 100, 1000 and so on, the product is the number itself followed by the same number of zeros as in the multiplier. Okay, so 4 into 10 here, 10 is the multiplier. So what will be the answer? You will write 4. Then in 10 we have 1 0, so we will put 1 0 after 4. So it is 40. Same way 4 into 100 we write 4. And in 100 we have 2 zeros, so we put 2 zeros, so 400. 4 into 1000 is 4000, so we write 4 and then we put 3 zeros after 4, so that is 4000. Okay, same way to multiply a number with other numbers that end in zeros, see the following examples. So here 7 into 20. Now 7 into 20 you can write it as 7 into 2 into 10. Also 7 2s is 14, so we write 14, and in 10 we have 1 0, so we'll put 1 0, so 140. Then 7 into 200, so 7 2s are 14, and in 200 we have 2 zeros, so we put 2 zeros after 14, so 1400, 1400. Same way 9 into 3000, 9 3s are 27, and here we have 3 zeros, so we'll put 3 zeros after 27, so that is 27,000. So these are the four properties of multiplication. Alright, now let's see a few questions on this. So page number 124. Okay, let's do questions on page number 124. So here they have told fill in the blanks using multiplication table. So use your tables to fill in the blanks. So how much is 8 5s are? 8 5s are is 40. So we'll write 40 here. Then 9 6s are. How much is 9 6s are? 9 6s are. If you see in the table, you'll get to know 9 6s are is 54. Okay, 6 9s are is 54. Then 7 7s are. How much is 7 7s are? 7 7s are is 49. Then 3 9s are. How much is 3 9s are? 3 9s are is 27. Then 5 tens are. How much is 5 tens are? 5 tens are 50. Then last one, 6 eights are. 6 eights are is how much? 6 eights are is 48. So this at home, what is there? You do that for homework. Okay. Next, fill in the blanks using properties of multiplication and multiplication table. So 57 into 0. First property, that is when you multiply a number with 0, the answer will be 0. So 57 into 0 is 0. Then 19 into 1, which is the second property, property of 1. When you multiply a number by 1, the answer will remain the number itself. So 19 into 1 is 19. Then 5 into 9 is equal to dash into dash is equal to dash. Okay, so here you can make this as the order property. So 5 into 9 is also equal to 9 into 5. Correct. 5 into 9 is also equal to 9 into 5. How much is 9 5s or 5 9s? It is 45. Then 9 into 3 into 2 is equal to dash into 6. Okay. Now here into 6 they have given. Now if you see 3 2s is 6. So they have multiplied 3 into 6. So that is we can write 9 here. So 9 into 6 is equal to dash into 2. So now which number is left? 2 is left. So it means they have multiplied 9 into 3. 9 3s is how much? It is 27. Okay, so 27 into 2. Now how much is 9 6s? 9 6s is 54. Okay, so the answer is 54. Now 4 into 5 into 3. So they have kept into 3 as it is. So multiplied 4 into 5 first. So how much is 4 5s? 4 5s is 20. Now here see they have put into 15. So 5 3s is 15. So it means they have kept 4 as it is. So 4 into 15. Now when you do 20 into 3 or 4. Now 20 into 3 how you can do? You can do 2 into 4. Not 20 into 3, sorry. 20 into 3. So what you can do? 2 into 3 you can do. 2 into 3 is 6. And then there's 1 0 in 20. So you can put 60. So the answer is 60. Okay, then these last three, last two problems, F and G, you can do for homework. Alright, then turn your pages to the next page. So we have complete the following here. So let's do these questions also. So 3 into 10, how much is 3 tens are? 3 tens are 30. Then 17 into 10. So how you will do this? You will write 17 as it is. In 10 we have 1 0, so we put 1 0, so 170. So 68 into 100. So what we do, we write 68, then in 100 we have two zeros, so we'll write two zeros, so 6,800. And then 9 into 1000, so we write 9, and then we have three zeros, so 1, 2, 3 zeros, so that is 9,000. Then 93 into 10, so how much is 93 into 10? First, what you will do, you'll write 93 as it is. In 10 we have 1 0, so we write 0, so 930. Okay, so 7 into 200. So what we'll do, we'll write 7 2s as how much? 14. And we write 2 zeros, 1400. So 71 into 100, so we write 71. And in 100 we have 2 zeros, so we put 2 zeros. Okay, then 5 into 3. 5 3s as how much? 5 3s as 15. And there is 1 0, so 150. Okay, so 12 into 500. So now here, 12 into 5 when you do, you get 60. Okay, and then there are two zeros, so that is 6,000. Okay, so this is how you do multiplication. These are the properties of multiplication. Okay, and then last three you'll do for homework again. Okay, and we'll continue with multiplication by one digit numbers in the next class. All right, I'll see you all in the next class, students. Thank you.